I'm called Atwiine Sabrina. I just finished my law school, just exams. Hopefully in November I'll graduate exams. And I come from Kavale district. Whoa, I didn't know I had people from Kavale. Good to see you. Yeah, so basically for me as a person, I have a very big heart for the education sector. How to make it a better place, how to make it meaningful, how to make it a process that can help everyone's potential be tapped into. Personally, I'm very passionate about people. I'm very passionate about processes. I'm very passionate about how we can harmonize all these with technology. And that explains mostly all the things that I've been doing. Yeah, so early this year, I joined my final semester in law school, and one of my thoughts was, after school, what are you going to do? So I found a startup called Nimarungi, and what we do basically at Nimarungi is that we harness the power of data, information, and capacity building programs to eradicate education inequality and influence resilience among learners and school-going children, and even those who have dropped out of school. Basically, the hope is that we can be able to use data to understand how this system works, understand student participation, understand the engagement of teachers and students, understand the available resources and opportunities, and use this information to visualize it, actualize it, and share it with the different stakeholders that contribute to the education sector. But the truth is that in our formal traditional schools, what we learn, there's a very big gap when we connect with what is needed later with the private sector. So that means that then, in the stakeholders that we have in the education sector, we definitely need to bridge the gap between the private sector and the public sector, which are the schools. The questions we want to ask ourselves is, how can we bridge this gap? And then for learners, what can we do to make sure that this private sector actually wants us? What can we do to even, you know, be better versions of ourselves? But I can definitely share four things or three things that have worked for me. One, resilience. Second, passion, which I also like to call grit. Third, persistence. And then the other, people. I look at people as a human force. I look at people as powerhouses. People have contributed the largest part of who I am, the things I've achieved, the knowledge I have, my potential being tapped into and realized. It has all been because of people. I have Phyllis over here. She's a very close friend of mine. And I started working with her in my senior five, senior six, around there, when I was participating in a program called Technovation. What Technovation does is that it challenges girls from underserved communities to identify problems in their communities and solve them using mobile applications. Like I already said, I come from an underserved community. By that time, when this program was introduced to my school, I didn't even know how to use a laptop or a computer. I didn't know how to turn a mouse. I didn't know right click, left click, and so many other people like me are struggling with the same. But with the help of people like Phyllis, mentors, the private sector being pushed into our schools, capacity building, learners are able to actualize their potential, their ability, their skills to turn into individuals or citizens that can eventually contribute to transforming communities and their families and themselves at large. I've been able to visit the biggest tech companies in the world. We are talking about Tesla, we are talking about Google, we are talking about Microsoft. Getting experiences and learning from all this just by showing up. I didn't have to do anything to make this organization see me for who I am and understand that I need this dream. So all you need is just show up, be available, get to know the ecosystems that share the same values like you and same interests. And at the end of the day, it is going to help you. I think next week, I'm going to be part of a panel at the United Nations High Forum that is going to be reviewing sustainable development goals, which are very pertinent in the innovation industry at the headquarters in New York. And all this, thank you. And all this, I've been able to get all these opportunities through being able to put myself out there, be ready to learn and learn, relearn each and every time. And people will always see you for who you are. People will always recommend you. People will always bring to you offers that you didn't even see coming. I don't want to waste much of our time, so I'll just call it a day. And I will, maybe my last remarks will be, I hope that each and every individual here can get to use their self, who they are, their grit, their passion, their persistence, their resilience to be a lighting force for any other person out there, to be able to inspire them, motivate them to be who they want to be. Thank you very much.